talk about Krishna in this episode, because Krishna talked about the technology of evolving involuntarily, that is naturally. That is what he showed to the world through Radha. Radha doesn't do meditation. Now she doesn't do. She is there even now. She doesn't meditate. Those days also she did not meditate. She doesn't know what is meditation. But how she is actually connected with Krishna, how she is the partner of Krishna, that is what it is. Because she meets the basic necessities of spirituality, that is surrender. Trust, faith, having all these things 100% in Krishna. It doesn't mean that you say that, you know, I surrender to Krishna. How do you prove that you have surrendered to Krishna? Krishna himself comes and then he is there as Guru. So you need to surrender to the Guru physically and prove that you have surrendered. Then it becomes the case of surrenderance. It becomes the proven case of surrendering. Till then you cannot just say in the air that, oh, I have surrendered to the God. What do you have surrendered? You cannot leave your ego. You have your individual will. You have your own preferences. You argue. You join some guru and then you argue with him. What's the point in joining the guru? So all these things, you know, are basics basically. She meets the basics. When you meet the basics, you don't need to meditate. Meditation happens all the time with you naturally. Involuntarily it will happen with you all the time. While talking to some people, while driving the car, while cooking food, while speaking to the customers, while talking to your boss, all the time it happens. You will be always in meditation. That is what happens with Radha. Radha doesn't know meditation. Radha doesn't meditate actually. But there is a different technology that Radha adopted. Apart from this, that technology you get to know in Omism lessons. The same thing goes with Parvati. Parvati doesn't meditate. Parvati, Radha, Lakshmi, Saraswati, they don't meditate. Yeah, Shiva, Vishnu, and Brahma and all, they meditate. That's a different thing. But Lakshmi, Parvati, Radha, all these are Prakriti. Prakriti would have Saguna. With Saguna related emotions. By surrendering 100% to their partners, they unite with their partner. And then they become Prakriti for their partner, for their Purusha. It doesn't happen that easily, as I said. It's a big journey. Parvati also doesn't meditate. Parvati as a Brahmacharini, one of her incarnations. Then only she meditated. But after that she didn't meditate. Even now she doesn't meditate. They remain as Prakriti. The partners for their Purushas. So the point that everybody needs to know is, by just doing meditation, things don't happen. By surrendering to the supernatural power, who appears in the form of Guru. Of course, these days Gurus are also not believable and trustworthy. That's your fate, what we can do. But there is a way to understand. That way you will know if you sign up with Omism lessons. The point that everybody needs to know is, meditation needs to happen. It's not done. And by not doing meditation, you can become something great. By not doing meditation, by taking up this route and another technology that is available in Ohmism lessons, you can adapt to the path of always happening meditation. You will naturally fall in the path of always happening meditation. So the point is all about surrendering and meditation happening naturally, not doing. So that's the technology that Krishna taught to the world. There were so many friends of Krishna those days, and with all of them meditation used to happen. He never used to tell them that you sit like this, you close your eyes, you do like this and meditate and all. He didn't teach the world meditation. So his campaign again goes in terms of spirituality: surrender to the divine 100%. Not just by mind and soul, also by physical appearance. You need to surrender. Then a very high level spiritual journey will start with you. That's the spiritual campaign of Krishna. The ninth incarnation is Buddha. Before actually talking about Buddha, we should talk about the another sub incarnations of Vishnu. His name is Kapila. Kapila is one of the incarnations of Vishnu. He taught the world the technology of Sankhya. Sankhya talks about mind, intellect, memory, five elements, body, and then ego. Only these things he talks about. He doesn't talk about consciousness and then God. It's pure knowledge and then technology based campaign that Kapila gave to the world. So it's pure A plus B whole square kind of algorithm that he gave to the world. And the same kind of algorithm that even Patanjali followed. This is the base for Patanjali actually. So Kapila talks about only A plus B whole square. God, please don't talk about God. Why he campaigned like that was, it's like a hill. Imagine. He talks about the process of going to the top of the hill. He only talks about going to the top of the hill with A plus B whole square journey, with this journey. Once you go here, you will anyway see what is there on the other side of the hill. You will know it. So there is no point in talking about what is there on the other side of the hill. The other side of the hill is about God and consciousness and all these things. So if anybody asks about God and consciousness, please don't talk about God and the consciousness and all these matters. Just follow this. So what happens if I follow this? If anybody asks this question to him, he would say he will climb the top of the hill. Then you will get to see what is there on the other side of the hill. What will I get to see? You may see God or whatever it is, or your own self, whatever it is. So that was his campaign. So, Kapila was this actually. He is the one who gave this A plus B whole square of yoga, first time to the world. It's called Sankhya. The same technology even Krishna talked about in Bhagavad Gita. So, this Buddha is actually the incarnation, the reincarnation of this guy, Kapila. So, he gets born in Kapilavastu. Buddha gets born in the city. His city is Kapilavastu, right? His father rules that region. Kapilavastu is the capital. So in Kapilavastu, he gets born Buddha. So Buddha actually is just another next version of Kapila. higher version of software. So he comes again, he gives the same A plus B whole square to the world. He also doesn't talk about God and all this. Don't talk about all these things. These are there in your control. These are like clutch, gear, brake, steering, wipers, and all these things of your car. So these operations, lights and all these operations are within your hands. You are not able to operate with your hands this car itself, and you are trying to talk about God. That is his philosophy, Buddha and Kapila also. Don't talk about something that is there superior. These things are there in your hands. You are required to control these things. So take the practice that actually lets you control this. That practice is A plus B whole square. Okay, take it up and then you go to the top of the hill. So that's the actual campaign Buddha gave to the world. When Buddha came, a lot of himsa used to be there in the world. Himsa means violence. So that is called so he came to teach the world ahimsa, non-violence. So when he came down, especially in the region of, he was born in Kapilavastu, which is one of the places in Nepal. So Nepal actually is a Tibet region. He was born there, especially in the region of China, Philippines, Japan, Singapore, and all these places. You know, lot of lot of violence used to take place. Violence, not in terms of killing humans. Even now it's the same case, right? That's the reason why you have the COVID here. So people eat lot of meat there. They kill various types of animals. They keep on eating animals. So he came down to show non-violence to the world, especially to that part of the world. But he took the birth in Nepal, which is close to India, where spirituality used to be quite prominent. So he taught non-violence, that is ahimsa, to the world by showing that A plus B whole square technology of controlling your mind, your intellect, your ego, your senses, and all these things. That is what is A plus B whole square technology. So he gave that A plus B whole square technology to the world to follow ahimsa. But what happened was his campaign not only went upward, but it came downward into India and Sri Lanka and all. That was not actually part of the cosmic plan. But because of his disciples and all, that Buddhism got spread to India and Sri Lanka region. So again, Shankaracharya had to come and then wipe out that Buddhism and its shadows in Sanatana Dharma. That's a different story altogether. So that's when Buddhism went out of Indian continent, and it got settled in China, Japan, and all these other parts of Asia, where it was meant to be actually. People now so proudly they say that people of that region, you know, Japanese, Chinese and all, they claim that Koreans, you know, they claim that they follow Buddhism. If they follow Buddhism, they are not supposed to be eating meat. They are not supposed to be killing animals. They are supposed to be following Ahimsa. But they say they follow Buddhism and they are so proud about it, without following the basics. That's the problem. So anyway, he came and then campaigned Buddham Sharanam Gachame, Dharmam Sharanam Gachame, and then Sangham Sharanam Gachame, which is part of this A plus B whole square technology. Buddham is actually Shuddham. Shuddham means very pure. Purest one. Buddham is always inward. The nucleus. The perfect being. That is supernatural power itself. He is called Buddham. Buddham surrender to it. Sharanam Gachami is what it means. Dharmam Sharanam Gachami. The laws of nature. He also campaigned about surrendering to the laws of nature, which is very, very, very essential in life. And then Sangham Sharanam Gachami. Sangham means society. That means actually you are required to choose some group of people who are into spiritual seeking. You shouldn't associate with people who go to disco bars or dance bars, who drink liquor, who take drugs and all. That doesn't mean Sangham, society, or not even ordinary people. Society means the society of people who are seeking spirituality. Associate with such people. That is what is Sangham Sharanam Gachami. So he gave the technology of this A plus B whole square to address the problem of Himsa. So he gave Ahimsa technology. The technology that you can follow, by which you can become non-violent. That is what is the campaign of Buddha.